Howdy, folks. I'm Stuart Heath, CEO of Harvard Grace Corporation, where we provide executive leadership tailored to your organization. In this week's tax tip, I want to talk to you about an article from the CPA Tax Advisor magazine. It's called IRS Offers Guidance for Employee Retention Credit and PPP Eligibility Rules. Yet another little-known piece of the CARES Act passed just about a year ago now is that there is an employee retention tax credit, which is exactly what it sounds like. If you maintained your payroll throughout the year, then you will get a tax credit. And of course, there's some interplay there with PPP loans and forgiveness of that. Which you got the forgiveness of the loan if you actually spent it mostly on payroll and the like. The credit is available to employers that retained and paid in qualified wages, which of course there's a definition for that, after March 12th, 2020 and before January 1st of 2021, and who experienced full or partial suspension of their operations or a significant decline in gross receipts. So there's a two-part test there, and people in a lot of parts of the country had to, shut down their business, or their business just declined, or you can do this gross receipts measurement if you had a significant decline. The credit's equal up to 50% of the qualified wages, and there's a cap on $10,000. The trick with the interplay of the PPP loan is you can't use the same payroll dollars used for the credit as you did for the forgiveness application. Shouldn't be a problem because if you recall, your PPP loan was based upon 2.5 months of your payroll or 8 weeks, and your recovery period was 24 weeks. So if you had operations at all, you almost certainly spent more in the 24-week period than you did in the 8-week measurement period. Sorry if that's a little too technical. Anyway, I think this is great news for employers. You should be thinking about this and talking to your tax advisors about that. So we'd love to discuss this with you. So give us a holler. Thanks.